Bienvenidos a España. How are you, my friends? Welcome to Montjuic. This is Darío. And today we're going to be racing the 1967 Trofeo Juan Jover, the Joan Jover Trophy. He was a Spanish Formula One driver. And this was a trophy made for him in Spain. And this is a Formula 2 non-championship event that, as you can see, we're going to be racing as Jackie Hicks, as always. And in this occasion, I'm not going to do the full race. It was very hard to find any information about this race. Actually, let me get in the cockpit and let's go around the track. This track, to begin with, is the 1975 track mod available in race department or whatever it's called now. It's the only one that I could find. Maybe this one older, but this is what I could find. And you can see all these Arco barriers that we have in here. 1967, of course, it wasn't there, but this is what we have. Still a very, very challenging track, because if you bounce with in these barriers, it's just safety, you know where it is. But it's very nice, this track still. And the information that I found actually was very, very dispar, because I have like information saying that the race took for 60 laps, but then I found on a Spanish, I'm Spanish, if this is the first time that you watch me, in a Spanish newspaper notice that I found online, he says that actually, look at that, how nice in the, at the end. It was two series of 20 laps each and then a final of 35 instead of a 60 lap race. So what I'm gonna do in this case, I'm just gonna race a 25 lap race, because you know, the last race that I did was at Po, 70 laps. It's too much. It takes a long time to practice. You have to, you know, with these walls and all that, it's very easy to crash. I'm just gonna make it the non-championship races at least. I'm gonna do a short race, and since we're racing with some F1 cars, because I couldn't find, I love this view from here. Look at that. At the end, the cathedral. At the it's very hard and takes a lot of practice, a lot of time. Can I see what it says there? No. Blah, 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 blah. We cannot see what it says. The directions. So, since we're doing using a Formula One car, as I mentioned, for like Jochen Rindt and the Brabhams, that I couldn't find the Brabhams BT23 that raced in this event. Look at that Jeep. that the Formula One cars could do the whole race without refueling, but the F2 cars that we are driving here with the Matra, Jackie Stewart, but terrible, he says there. corre, corre, moda masculina. We're gonna do a 25 laps that I can do with one fuel tank, so nobody has to pit, and we are in the same, nobody has an advantage. The grid more or less is similar to what we had, very close to it, and the key here is gonna be at the beginning, see if I can pass all the Formula 3 cars and Formula 2 cars that the same as mine, so I can catch up with the Formula 1 drivers, and then I have a chance to pass them and see if we can win the race. This was non-championship points, so there was no points for anybody. It's just prize money. I have no idea, Coca-Cola. I have no idea how much money actually was for the prize money, but for the glamour and all that, everybody wants to win. And after a fiasco at Po, that we DNF on lap 62 of the 70, this is very, very short, but very complicated track. But anyway, let's get into it, 25 laps, and let's see what we can do. Thank you. Well, that was a nice race, guys. A nice victory. They give us some prize money and some confidence for the following events. You can see here, let me turn it up. We won with a 5.8 second margin. That is not that much. You can have any little mistake, clip an arm cord, a railing on the sides, and yeah, the race is all over. So I'm pretty happy with that. Jochen Rindt finished in second with the Cooper, is a Formula One car. And then we have Graham Hill, Jim Clark, that actually was the winner in real life. And then Josep Vidal, all the Matras. And here you see that the Formula One cars actually didn't do, except Jochen Rindt. The Brabham here in seventh. And I think we saw Denny Hulme that had a ton of trouble. Who is he? Where are you? Denny Hulme, 19th. I don't know, we crossed path with him and we lapped him a few times, actually. He was having trouble for sure, but I don't know why he didn't go into pits to fix whatever he had. I don't know. He just kept from the beginning. Only one car retired on the first lap, and that's it. All the other cars finished, so that's pretty nice. You can see in real life that actually Jim Clark won with the Lotus 48. I couldn't find this model, that's why he drove with a Matra. Jochen Rindt finished second, but all these guys with a Brabham BT23 that I don't have. We have the Brabham BT24, so I gave them this the Formula One car to race. And you can see also Alan Rees, some of these guys that in real life participated with better cars. I gave them F3 cars because it's what I had to with them, and some of them are fictional, but anyway, here we have you can see the results. Actually 7 cars qualified, but only 5 finish the race, because these two not running, engine not running, blah blah blah. So only 5 actually finish the whole race. So we did much better. Our settings, if you are wondering, so the opponent strength was at 90, the same as in Po. Opponent aggression at 20, maybe that's why so many of them finished. But I was afraid that if I turn this up, actually they just keep crashing and they don't finish. Everything else is at times one, the fuel, etc., just to make sure that we could all do it in one run, the same as the Formula One cars. And the next one will be at Ulton Park. You can see here the online website that I found. We have the whole season. The next one is the Spring Trophy at Ulton Park, that is in conjunction with Formula One. So this was Formula One, Formula Two, but non-championship points. So it's just for the prize money and for the glory. And I believe in here we won't have Jim Clark participating. I have to check it. Let's check it right now, because I think 1967 was the year that Jim Clark was changing the fiscal country, is what the word I was looking for. So in Great Britain, the tax that they had to pay is 95% of their earnings. So you can imagine the risking their lives in these circuits to give all the money away. It was not nice. So Jim Clark, I think in 1967, he was moving his fiscal country to France. He moved to Paris, and for that to happen during a full year, 1 year period, he couldn't set foot on British soil. So that's why in the previous races that we have been doing here, like the Formula 2, Snetterton, that you can check on the channel if you haven't watched it, we raced at Snetterton and Silverstone, and these were championship points. The Formula One drivers are great at drivers, they don't get points, but they go there for the prize money and to race. He didn't took part, and as we can see, the next one is in Ulton Park in Great Britain, and he's not here as well. So Brabham, Jackie Oliver, Graham Hill, Jim Clark is not here, so I think that was the reason why. He was in at Po, actually, right? The previous race that we did at Po, if I remember correctly, he was there. Yeah, he was there. So that's the reason. I think that's why. And the next year, actually, I don't remember. I think it's 68 or 69, something like that. Jackie Stewart, actually, he moved to Switzerland. Well, the following year, it was right after Jim Clark. But anyway, that's just anecdotes. So next event that we're gonna do is gonna be the Spring Trophy 1967 at Ulton Park. And I don't know why there are so many that didn't arrive. But yeah, we'll have to see. That's gonna be for the next one. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, let me know in the comments if you want to try the links or all the mods, the track, the cars, etc. As always, will be in the video description. And yeah, I'm gonna leave it here for now, and I start training for Ulton Park. Thank you very much for your time. Please take care, be safe, and I hope to see you soon with the next video. Bye bye for now.